New England is home to some of the most valuable fisheries in the United States. Whether it's lobster or scallops or swordfish, ocean life off the coast of New England is plentiful.
It's our heritage. It's where we all came from. The first Europeans who came to New England came here for fish.
NOAA's regional Gloucester, Massachusetts operation monitors and manages overfishing in the North Atlantic waters.
So NOAA's obligation to prevent the decline in fisheries is to use science to understand how many fish there are in the ocean now and how many are going to be there next year. And that gives us the right number to tell fishermen how many fish they can catch in a year.
Simply put, these fishing limitations are applied in order to make sure that there is still going to be enough fish swimming around.
It's very dynamic with changes all the time. The fish change all the time and the regulations are behind the fish. Overfishing is very difficult to manage, since I think they do their best with what they have.
If we don't maintain our healthy fish stocks, then fishermen go out of business.
In Boston, one place where folks in the area can get up close to actual marine life is the New England Aquarium.
I really like the turtle and the jellyfish.
I went here for the stingray touch tank. It's one of my favorite parts of the aquarium.
I touch eels. When you touch them, it feels like you're touching wet slime.
My favorite thing that I saw were the African penguins.
Since the COVID pandemic in 2020, the number of aquarium visitors declined.
But I'm happy to report that we are tracking back to 2019 numbers. People are coming back. We are happy to be part of the revitalization of the city.
The aquarium says it directs 73% of its expenses towards protection.
Our main mission and goal at the New England Aquarium is to protect our oceans for future generations.
Our oceans are becoming more healthy around here. Our harbors are cleaner and safer, and in turn our seal species has increased as well.
Today, about 600 different animals populate this aquarium's giant ocean tank, including the notorious Myrtle the Turtle.
She is the largest and oldest resident of the aquarium. She is about 90 years old and she is 502 pounds. What Myrtle wants, Myrtle gets.
From magical Myrtle to the sporty seals to the fabulous fish, these days keeping the ocean fully operational means keeping it healthy.
If we all work together and, you know, follow all of the same guidelines and rules, we could have a sustainable and healthy ocean.
So the stronger the ocean, the stronger our planet.